François Ravaillac was born in Touvre, near Angoulême, in September 1578. He was born in a region which was severely traumatized by the French religious war. His father was secretary to the mayor of Angoulême and had a violent temper. After losing his job in 1588, Ravaillac's father became an alcoholic. His mother, Catherine François Dubreuil, was known to be a pious and charitable woman. Ravaillac's father squandered his wife's money, leaving the family destitute. François Ravaillac started his working career at the age of 11 as a clerk in a law office in Angoulême. Later on, he became a schoolmaster teaching catechism. Both jobs were badly paid, so much so that Ravaillac was reduced to living in a condition close to this of being a beggar. Desperate and covered in fleas, Ravaillac unsuccessfully tried to join a few religious orders. In particular, his request to join the Order of the Feuillants was rejected after a brief novitiate, as he appeared to be in the grip of mystical visions. In 1608, Ravaillac went to Paris upon request of the Duc d'Epernon to follow the developments in a civil case at the Parisian court. In Paris, Ravaillac frequented the Catholic circles, which were angry with Henri IV after the Edict of Nantes. They accused the king, rightfully so, of having converted to Catholicism only to obtain the French throne. It was in these circles of ardent papists that Ravaillac sharpened his hatred of Protestants. Shortly afterwards, Ravaillac left Paris for other small assignments, again commissioned by the Duc d'Epernon. In 1609, he claimed to have had a vision in which he was ordered to persuade Henry IV to convert the Huguenots to Catholicism. In order to communicate these visions to the king, he traveled three times to Paris between 1609 and 1610. Ravaillac failed to meet the king, and when Henry IV decided to invade the Spanish Netherlands, Ravaillac interpreted this decision as a decision by the monarch to start a war against Pope Paul V and against God. Determined to stop Henry IV's attack on the papacy, he decided to kill him. A few weeks before the crime, Ravaillac had stolen a double-bladed knife from a small inn with the aim of killing the king. However, he changed his mind several times and, advised by a Jesuit priest during confession, Ravaillac decided to return to Angoulême. However, during this trip, Ravaillac changed his mind once more and returned to Paris. On May 14, 1610, Henry IV left the Louvre Palace for a visit to his Protestant Minister of Finance, the Duc de Sully, who was suffering from influenza. The king wished to pass through the streets of Paris anonymously, so he was not accompanied by the guards on horseback, but contented himself with only a small escort of foot soldiers. At around 4:15 p.m., the carriage came to a halt in the narrow Rue de la Ferronnerie. Ravaillac jumped onto the carriage and, quickly drawing his knife, struck three times. Ravaillac's weapon penetrated Henry IV's body twice, near the armpit, without causing major damage, and then between the second and third ribs, delivering a fatal blow to Henri's right lung. Henri IV died in his carriage. Ravaillac did not flee and remained motionless, immediately arrested by Marshal de la Force to save him from being lynched by an angry mob. He was first taken to the Hotel de Retz and then transferred to the Conciergerie, where Robert François Damien, guilty of the attempted regicide of Louis XV of France, would also be locked up more than a century later in 1757. During his interrogations, Ravaillac was repeatedly tortured to force him to reveal the names of his accomplices, but he always claimed to have acted alone. He showed regret for his act, but was convinced that he was an instrument of God. 13 days later, on May 27, 1610, by decision of the Parliament of Paris, François Ravaillac was executed at the Place de Grève by quartering. His arms and legs were tied to four horses, which were then moved in opposite direction. Even shortly before the execution took place, he denied to his confessor that he had any accomplices. Ravaillac's house was demolished, his parents were exiled, and the rest of the family was ordered to stop using the surname Ravaillac. A year before Henri IV's murder, in 1609, Jacqueline d'Escoman, lady-in-waiting of Henriette d'Entragues, Marquise de Verneuil, repeatedly declared that she suspected a plot against the king organized by the Marquise de Verneuil and the Duc d'Epernon. D'Escoman was silenced and imprisoned in the Conciergerie on the charge of abandoning her children. Freed in January 1611, she again accused the Duke and the Marquise of being responsible for the death of Henri IV. The two parties were interrogated, but the matter ended with the accused being dismissed, while the accuser, Madame d'Escoman, was convicted of slander and imprisoned for the remainder of her life. In the years following the regicide, it became known that Ravaillac had been part of a group of religious fanatics called Octagonus, whose members were recognized by the use of a symbol, an octagon with the name of Jesus written on each side, which was found on a parchment carried by Ravaillac. There is little information about this secret organization, but many scholars believe it to be a spy organization founded by Pope Pius V, mainly in an anti-Protestant capacity. Thank you for watching.